If you sign into your Hydrawise account and you notice a red triangle, don't worry. This is a no internet connection message, and this message indicates that the controller is not fully connected to the network. We detect this within about 7 minutes for all Hydrawise controllers except for the HC models with firmware version 1.89 or 2.05. These HC controllers take up to about 7 hours to indicate that there is no internet connection. If you have the X2 controller with WAN Wi-Fi module, please visit the support page and visit the X2 troubleshooting guide. When the controller is offline, it will continue to water the default watering schedule as it's stored on the memory of the controller. Any changes you make to your settings and schedules through the app will only update to the controller when it reconnects to the internet. In addition, no reporting and weather adjustments or predictive watering triggers will apply while offline. An important item to remember is if you see the message in wireless settings connected, Wi-Fi connected successfully, or the full bar's Wi-Fi icon, this does not always indicate that you are completely connected to the server. Please check the connection status to view if you are fully connected. To check the connection status from the controller, go to the home screen on the controller and select Status. Then select Connection Status. A successful connection to the Hydrawise server is indicated by the last sync under 1 minute, or a message that says connected, updated a certain amount of time ago as the server status. The controller is connected to Hydrawise and received a configuration update X amount of seconds ago. This is the normal status. Under connection status, if you see disconnected, an unsuccessful connection to the router is indicated by the following phrases. Can't find Wi-Fi access point, wireless down, no internet, or last sync 1 minute or greater as shown on the server status. The controller is not connected to the router. Here are your troubleshooting steps. Check that your wireless router and controller are powered on. Verify serial numbers in the software match the number in the controller status screen. You'll want to check the serial number on the controller as well as go into the Hydrawise app under controller settings and verify that the serial number matches what's on the controller. You may also need to perform a signal strength check. A medium signal of -75 dBm or less is needed in order to connect and maintain connection. To test this, go to Settings, Wireless, Wireless Name, Select Network, and Read Strength. You may also need to reboot your controller. Go to Settings, Config, then reboot your controller and check the connection status. Resetting the controller to factory default may be necessary. To do so, click Settings, then click Config, click Factory Default, then click Erase Config. Now visit the Connection Wizard and check connection status. After these steps at the controller, you may need to move to the modem and router. Unplug it for 15 to 20 seconds, then plug it back in and wait about 2 to 3 minutes for it to reset. Then go check your connection status at the Check Connection Status screen. If you're using a Wi-Fi extender or Wi-Fi booster, it's important to reset that as well. If you're using a Wi-Fi hotspot for connection, be sure to power that down and repower that to see if you regain connection to the server. If all else fails, check your network settings. Be sure to note that Hydrawise controllers work with 802.11 BGN networks, with the exception of the HC controller, which is only compatible with 802.11 B and G networks. It's also important to remember that Hydrawise controllers only work with 2.4 GHz networks. Most modern network routers come with a dual band network. This means that it provides a 2.4 GHz network as well as a 5 GHz network. Some routers are auto-selecting, which means it will choose the network that it thinks is correct for that device. It's important when you're setting up the Wi-Fi on your Hydrawise controller to select that 2.4 GHz network. 2.4 GHz actually has a larger range than 5 GHz networks, so it's actually a better connection overall for the Hydrawise controller. Now, if you use a Wi-Fi signal strength reader, you can see what channels are selected. The router channels should be between 1 and 11. Anything over 11 indicates that that's a 5 gigahertz network. So if it's mislabeled in the Wi-Fi router, you may be trying to connect to a 5 gigahertz network, so make sure that the channel is between 1 and 11. Hydrawise supports security types of WPA or WPA2. Hydrawise cannot connect to guest networks or networks with portal page logins. For more information about outbound ports and inbound ports, visit the support page on Hydrawise.com.